in progress. Work in, that you are, work in, your family is work in, our nation is work in progress. Jina Bwana lipewe sifa. Na kwa hivyo ningetaka kusema ya kwamba, wakati unapoangalia maisha yako, there are times unaweza kuwa frustrated. Praise the name of the living God. By your shortcomings. You can be frustrated. Wakati unaangalia udhaifu ambao uko nao katika maisha yako. Na unashindwa. Je, mimi nitawahi kuwa chombo cha maana ambacho kinaweza kutumika kufanya kazi ya heshima. Lakini ningetaka tuendelee kupata encouragement kutoka kwa neno hili Paul ambalo aliandikia kanisa la Wafilipi. Kumbuka Philippians chapter 1, Paul alikuwa anaandika kitabu hiki akiwa kwa gereza. Lakini kwa sababu alikuwa ameanzisha kanisa hili, akaamua ya kwamba angependa kuandikia barua ya kuatia moyo hata walipokuwa wanamtumia msaada akiwa gerezani. In Philippians chapter 1 and verse 6, Paul akawa anawatia moyo na anawaambia kwamba let's begin from verse 5. The Bible says, because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now, anawaambia, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of our Christ Jesus. Praise the name of the living God. Paul akawa anawaambia kanisa la Wafilipi, musiangalie udhaifu mnaoona. Musiangalie kasoro mnazoona. Nataka niwahakikishie na niko na ujasiri, I am confident ya kwamba he who began a good work in you will bring it to completion. Those are very encouraging words for someone who is looking at their lives. Remember how hard sometimes it is to forgive other people, who have offended you. But remember also how sometimes it is also very hard to forgive yourself. Unakuta ya kwamba kuna mambo katika maisha yako, unaangalia na unasema, hii singefanya, hii njia singepitia. Praise the name of the living God. Lakini unasahau ya kwamba, God is able to cause all things to work for good. Wakati hii nyumba ilikuwa inajengwa, I remember kuna wakati tuliweka miti hapa for almost 1 year tukitengeneza hii ceiling. And sometimes ningeingia hapa unakuwa frustrated, unashindwa. Many times ningekuja ninapanda huku juu, ninashindwa hii ceiling itaisha siku gani. Inatumia pesa. Praise, it was not easy. Praise the name of the living God. And today I want us to look at the book of Zechariah chapter 4 from verse 1. Because it can also be able to paint a good picture for us in this message. The Bible says, then the angel who talked with me returned and wakened me as a man is wakened from his sleep. He asked me, what do you see? I answered, I see a solid gold lampstand at the top and 7 lights on it with 7 channels to the right. Also there are 2 olive trees by it, one on the right of the bull and the other on its left. I asked the angel who talked with me, what are these, my Lord? He answered, do you not know what these are? No, my Lord, I replied. So he said to me, this is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord Almighty. What are you, O mountain, before Zerubbabel? You become a level ground. Then you bring out the capstone to shout of God bless it, God bless it. Then the word of the Lord came to me. The hands of Zerubbabel have laid the foundation of this temple. His hands will also complete it. Then you know that the Lord Almighty has sent me to you. Then verse 10, the Bible says, who despises the day of small things? Men will rejoice when they see the plumb line in the hand of Zerubbabel. These are the seven eyes of the Lord which lay throughout the earth. Praise the name of the living God. Haya ni maono ambayo mtumishi wa Mungu aliletewa, Zekaria aliletewa na maraika. Wakati mwingine Mungu huwa anataka kutuonyesha, because yeye anaitwa mwanzo na mwisho. Mungu anaweza taka kukuonyesha mahali uko na mahali anakupeleka. Because you know, human beings, we judge things as we see them. We judge what we see. But we are not able to see beyond the physical. That is why Paul said that we don't know one another after the flesh. Praise the name of the living God. Sasa katika maono haya ya Zekaria, he saw a very unusual thing. Wakati huu, ni wakati wana wa Israeli walikuwa wamerudi katika inchi yao. Na wakati ule, ilikuwa ni baada ya hekalu kubomolewa. Na huyu Zerubbabel alikuwa die governor. Die alikuwa nasimamia Jerusalem wakati huo. Na yeye ndiye alikuwa na kazi ngumu ya kusimamia ujenzi tena wa hekalu. Mahali hekalu ilikuwa imebomolewa, kumejaa takataka. Inakama, yani it was a heap of rumble. Praise the name of the living God. Na Mungu akamuamusha ama akamtuma maraika wake. Akaenda akamuamusha Zekaria. Akaanza kumuonyesha something that was never there in the temple. You know, in the temple, there was a lampstand. Na hiyo lampstand kuna vile ilikuwa na mikono tatu pande hii, na mikono tatu pande hii, na mkono moja katikati, na hizo in the top kulikuwa na utambi saba. Na one of the tedious work ya kuhani ilikuwa ni kuja kuweka mafuta, kukata utambi, na kumake sure ya kwamba the lamps are burning. It was a tedious work. Lakini Mungu akamuonyesha Zerubbabel kitu cha tofauti sana. Akamuonyesha the lampstand, lakini akamuonyesha there are two olive trees. Praise the name of the living God. Give us verse 12. Zechariah chapter 4 verse 12. Akaonyeshwa in verse 12 Biblia sema, again I asked, what are these two olive branches beside the two gold pipes that pour out golden oil? Yani akaona katika ile miti miwili kuna mifereji. From the olive trees kuna mifereji imetoka. Na hiyo mifereji diyo ina feed the lamps na mafuta. It was not that way in the natural. Lakini God is trying to show Zechariah that over and above the tedious work that was done by men in the temple, there was a supernatural provision of God that was happening. And remember now, by the time God is showing him, the temple is not there. There is nowhere even to put the lampstand. The lampstand. Ni kama uonyeshwe uko kwa madhabahu kama ya unahubiri, na nyumba kama hii hata haijajengwa. Sasa Mungu anamuonyesha kule mwisho. Na anamuonyesha ya kwamba hii nyumba ambayo inaonekana kama ni mulima. Praise the name of the living God. Itakuja kujengwa. There will be supernatural provision praise the name of the living God, hallelujah, na the lampstand itarudi mahali pake na itakuwa inafidiwa na mafuta in a supernatural way. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Sasa maraika akamwambia Zekaria, lazima umwambie Zerubabeli ya kwamba wewe mulima, because the building of a temple seemed like a mountain. These are people who have come from exile. They are still suffering a lot of mockery and opposition without enough resources. Lakini Mungu akamwambia, nani wewe mulima ambaye uko bere ya Zerubabel? Praise the name of the living God. Utangolewa, utaondolewa. Na hili jambo linaloonekana kama ni ngumu kufanyika, litafanyika. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Na litafanyika namna gani? Not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. Ni mimi nitafanya iwezekane. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. This was a very encouraging dream. This was a very unusual dream. Unaonyeshwa kule mwisho. Anaambiwa ya kwamba hii kazi ambayo Zerubabeli ameianza, ambaye ameweka jiwe la msingi, yeye pia ndiye atakuja kuweka the capstone. Yeye ndiye atakaye malizia. Na atakapo malizia, there will be shout of grace. Grace. Ni kwa sababu gani? Wataiona neema ya Bwana katika kuijenga tena hekalu ya Bwana. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. I come to encourage someone today. Praise the name of the living God. Don't despise the humble beginnings. Don't despise where you are today. Praise the name of the living God. I look back where we have come from and I am encouraged. I look back where we have come from and I am inspired. Praise the name of the living God, because I know he who began a good work is able to bring it to perfection. Praise the name of the living God. And I continue to surrender to him. I continue to connect my life to him. In the mighty name of Jesus, I continue to connect this vision to him, because there is one who began a good work. You remember in the book of Ezra, chapter 3, wakati walisherekea, is it chapter 3 verse 12? Wakati walisherekea the foundation, lakini kukakuja kukawa na upinzani baadaye, na nyumba ya Bwana ikasimama, inasema, but many of the older priests and the Levites and family heads who had seen the former temple wept aloud when they saw the foundation of this temple being laid, while many others shouted for joy. Praise the name of the living God. Hata baada ya kuwekwa msingi, there came a lot of opposition na ile kazi kasimama. Oh, nimekuja nikwambie siku ya leo, sijari ni nini mesimama katika maisha yako, lakini kama ni Mungu alianzisha, anakuja kumaliza katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Sijui ni inaonekana ni kama haiendelei. Inawezekana ni maisha yako inaonekana ni kama hakuna mahali unaenda. Na kutangazia wiki hii tunapoingia, maombi tutakayoomba ni ya kwamba he who began a good work. Praise the name of the living God. Maombi tutakayoomba ni ya kwamba not by might, in the mighty name of Jesus, not by power. Maombi tutakayoomba wiki hii ni ya kwamba let there be grace sufficient to continue with the work that you have begun. In the mighty name of Jesus, I declare divine activation in your life. Everything that God began and it has stagnated, let there be divine activation in the mighty name of Jesus, because there is one who began a good work. Praise the name of the living God. Sometimes I'm patient with people because I understand they are still work in progress. Even when you know their weaknesses, even when you know their shortcomings, you need to be patient with them, because as long as they are willing that God is going to continue working in their eyes, there is still hope. Praise the name of the living God. Sometimes you need to be patient with that marriage. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. If I was not patient with my marriage, there were times, tungiangalia, especially or the first to that year of marriage, munakuta ya kwamba it's like, you know, before you become compatible with one another, you come from different backgrounds, you have different tastes. Huyu anataka kukula doma asubuhi, na huyu anasema mimi doma nikiziona, ninasikia kiungulia. Anasema na mimi sijui huyu anataka mkate ya brown, huyu anataka ya white, na hakuna mkate inakuanga package brown na white. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Huyu anataka akule mayai ikiwa kwa mkorogo ya unga ya gano. Huyu naye anasema mayai yangu ni kule ikiwa mayai. Jina Bwana ipewe sifa. Before you become compatible with one another, it is a journey. You need to be patient with one another, because if it is God who began that marriage, he who began that good work will bring it to perfection. Praise the name of the living God. Oh my God, sometimes you need to be patient with your business. Some of the biggest companies in the world, they began from a humble beginning. They are founders. They came to the point of giving up. They did not even have enough resources to see how they are going to fund those businesses. But patiently, they endured. They fought. Praise the name of the living God. Until today, you see great establishments. Jina Bwana ipewe sifa. Nakumbuka wakati moja tulikuwa tuko na deni kubwa. Na ilikuwa inanisumbua. You know, sometimes we don't tell you everything. Because sometimes even if we tell you, you may not help. Bwana asifiwe sana. And even sometimes, even if you may help, sometimes God restrains you. And he tells you, don't give people burdens. Deal with me. I have no time to deal with God alone. Praise the name of the living God. So I was under pressure. And I remember usiku moja, niliamuka katika ndoto. Sio katika ndoto, katika usingizi. Niko under pressure. Nikaamuka, nikaanza kutingiza kichwa. Jina Bwana ipewe sifa. Unasumbuka, unajaribu kutafuta njia. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Unaona giza wakati mwingine. But I have come to encourage you, he who began a good work. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. Praise the name of the living God. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 2. Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 2. The Bible says, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Praise the name of the living God. The Bible says, there is one who began a good work in you. There is one who is the author and the perfecter, who is the beginner and the finisher of that good work in your life. The Bible says, fix your eyes unto him. Praise the name of the living God. The Bible says, who scorned the cross and endured the shame. Praise the name of the Lord. And he is now seated at the right hand of the Father. When you see people in places of glory, remember there was a time they were in a place of endurance. Praise the name of the living God. Yes, we like to see and we celebrate people when they are in a place of glory. But sometimes when they give you the story of their endurance, praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. You may say, I don't want the glory. And the Bible says, if we share in his sufferings, we are also going to share in his glory. Many people want to share in the glory, but they don't want to share in the suffering. They don't want to endure anything. They don't want to stand up for their faith and be counted. They don't want to pay any cost. They don't want to fight any battle. But I want to tell you, sometimes things are not going to be smoother as you'd have wanted. Praise the name of the living God. Things are not going to be smooth. Na sawa, wakati mwingine ni wewe huwa unajitania. Unamwambia Bwana nataka unitumie. Nataka nione ukuu wako. Oh, nataka mataifa yasherekee. Kipao umenipatia. You want to be in a place of glory. But before you get there, the Bible says, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith. The Bible says, who for the joy set before him, he did what? He endured scorning. You know, to scorn is shame. Yani unasema, hi yaibu, sio kitu. Hi yaibu, nikiangalia furaha, nikiangalia utukufu, hi yaibu ni kitu kidogo. Kuna mambo tunafaa tuangalie katika maisha yetu. Tukiona thawabu ambayo tumewekewa, tunasema hii ni kitu kidogo. Hii ni kitu kidogo. Praise the name of the living God. This is a sacrifice that I can pay. Praise the name of the living God. Because I see the joy. Praise the name of the living God. Sometimes it is not easy to undertake projects. And we know, sometimes it's so overwhelming. Sometimes it is so draining. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. But one of the things I have learned is to walk with God and depend on his strength. You know, many people can celebrate the progress, but they don't understand sometimes it's so overwhelming when the work is in progress. We can celebrate the glory when the work is finished, when things are happening. We can celebrate the miracles. We can celebrate a move of God. And many would like to see a mighty move of God. But how many are ready for the cost? How many are ready to scorn the shame? How many are ready? Some of you hata kufunga ni shida because unasema sasa, ninaona ninafunga mifupa inatokea. Sasa hata isipotokea, kuna mwanadamu anapelekana kwa butchery. Ha? Na mifupa ikitokea, itatokea kwa muda. Praise the name of the living God. Utaibika tu kwa muda. Yesu alisema, hii aibu, hii ni kidogo. Hii sio kitu. Nikiangalia ile furaha, nikiangalia watu wale wataokoka, wale watapona, nikiangalia watu wale hatima zao zitabadilishwa, wataondolewa kwa laana, watakombolewa na nguvu za giza. Akaangalia hiyo furaha ya siku ya leo tukiwa tumekusanyika kwa sababu ya kazi ya msalaba, wengi tukiwa tunafurahia yale Bwana ameyatenda. Akasema hiyo ni furaha kubwa. Praise the name of the living God. One of the reasons that help people to pay the cost is when you see the joy and you keep on pressing on. You tell God, I know you can move in the nations. I know people can see your glory in a greater way. I thank you for where I am. But I know there is still a higher level. I will never settle for less. I will continue to press on that I may get hold for that which Christ Jesus has gotten hold for me. Praise the name of the living God. Because I see the joy of people who are in bondage being set free. I see the joy of marriages being restored. I see the joy of people who have been made useless becoming useful. in their lives, in their families, in our nation. Praise the name of the living God. I see the joy of parents rejoicing because of their sons and daughters who are in a drug addiction, but now they are saved. Their husbands were not coming home, but now they are at home and having time to pray together with the family. Such joy will cause me to scorn the shame. I see the sufferings of those who are in pain because of different sicknesses afflicted by the enemy, and it is not the will of God for them to suffer. I see the joy when they come out of their sick bed, when they come out of their wheelchairs, when they come out of their affliction. I see the joy, and I am ready to pay the cost. I am ready to continue seeking you. I am ready to lay my life, because unless a kernel of wheat falls down and it dies, it abides alone. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. I see the joy. I see the joy of a generation that have never seen the glory of God. Oh, my Father, when they see your glory, they will know that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. I see the joy of a generation that is in bondage because of many things. In the mighty name of Jesus, when they receive the touch of your power, I see the joy in the mighty name of Jesus of them that are in prison houses, coming out of their prisons in the mighty name of Jesus. I see the joy of families that have been held back by evil foundations, and those foundations being broken in the name of Jesus, and releasing those families to their divine destiny. I see the joy, and I surrender to you. I am still work in progress, and I yield my life. Continue, Lord, working in my life. I know one day, in the name of Jesus, even though I go through affliction, even though I go through suffering, I know one day I'll come out as God. I'll reflect your glory. Today, I may not look like it, but one day, in the name of Jesus, as you continue to work on my weaknesses, to work on my shortcomings, oh my God, I know one day, in the mighty name of Jesus, sometimes I am discouraged. Sometimes I am on the verge of giving up. Sometimes I feel like the cost is too high for me. But when I see the joy in the mighty name of Jesus, when I see the glory, when I see the finished work, when I see the end, I continue to surrender. And I ask of you, Lord, continue, Lord, working in my life. Koriba shanda rabaganda rabazanda. Reka baganda bashanda. Don't you see the joy when you sponsor that orphan child and you see them wearing the gown as they receive their degree? Don't you see the joy when God has been able to bless you financially and you can be able to educate in the mighty name of Jesus those who are less fortunate? You can be able to give them a better house in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't you see the joy in the mighty name of Jesus? May God have mercy upon us that we are not going to settle for less, that someone will surrender and tell the Lord, I am still work in progress. Continue working in my life. I know there is a good work that you have begun in me. It is not by might. It is not by power. In the mighty name of Jesus, Koriba shanda baganda. Don't judge me by my weaknesses. I am still work in progress. Rekamaganda bashanda baganda. Don't judge me by where I am. Don't judge me by the things I'm not able to do today. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am still work in progress. Don't worry the shame that is in my life today. God is going to turn my shame into glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, and many will celebrate. Don't worry the fire that I am going through. One day I will come out as pure gold. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because fire is part of the process, is part of the making. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am still work in progress. Don't worry about my debts. It is part of the making. In the mighty name of Jesus, one day when someone will come to me and they'll tell me they are in debt, I'll be able to be touched by their infirmities because I know what they are going through. Once I was there, and so I can be able in the mighty name of Jesus to be touched by their infirmities, by their afflictions, in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't ask me why are you sick and you believe in a mighty God. It is part of the process. My sickness is just a preparation of a healing anointing that God wants to release in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus, don't ask me why things are falling apart in my family, in my life. It is part of the preparation. Oh my God, sometimes you have to destroy to be able to build. In the mighty name of Jesus, it is because God is able to do a new thing in my life. That is why he is dealing with the old so that the new can come. Sometimes God comes, he destroys your business, come down in the mighty name of Jesus. Things are not working anymore because he has qualified you for another level. The Bible says it is from glory to glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, when he qualifies you to another level of glory, you may see things falling apart and you're asking many questions. In the mighty name of Jesus, why is this happening to me? And the way I've been praying, the way I've been fasting, it is an answer to your prayer. You are still work in progress, and he who began a good work will come and bring it to completion. Fix your eyes unto Jesus, because he is the author and the finisher and the perfecter of your faith.